In this short video, we show you how to update your Orbit module to the latest firmware. The firmware is transferred to the module by playing back an audio file. When the module is switched on, the red LED flashes as often as the current firmware number of your module. So blinking once stands for firmware version 1, blinking twice for version 2, and so on. As a playback device, any device such as a computer, tablet or cell phone with check output and line level can be used. In this demonstration, we use a laptop. To update the firmware, we first download the latest firmware from Orbit's website. To do this, open the browser and go to www.neuzeit-instruments.com/orbit and download the latest firmware from the bottom of the page as a WAV file. Here, you can also see what has changed between versions and decide for yourself whether you want to update the firmware or not. Now, load the downloaded audio file into a media player of your choice. It is important to set the volume of the audio output to 100%. Also, no system sounds should be heard during the update process. We use a normal Eurorack cable from the stereo output of the player into audio input 1 of Orbit. Also, patch the audio output into a speaker so that we can hear the output of Orbit for reference. Set the potentiometers of Orbit as follows. Input 1 to the center position, input 2 to 0%, the bass equalizer to the center position and the wet control to 100%. The positions of the other potentiometers do not matter. Now we turn the assistant on again while the sync button is pressed. When releasing the sync button, Orbit will now start in maintenance mode. Make sure that no noise or hissing is audible in the normal state. Only after the sync button is pressed again, the data transmission is active. From now on, Orbit is armed and interprets everything from the audio input as data, which is written to the memory. Note that by pressing the sync button again initially, no change should be visible on Orbit's LEDs. We will now start playback of the firmware audio file. As soon as playback starts, the LED color of the envelope button changes to red and the bitcrusher buttons change over time. The playback time is about 5 minutes. During this time, it is best to leave the computer alone. Turn the dry knob back to 0% if you want. After the transmission is complete, the envelope LED will jump back to blue. Now turn your rack off and on again. Orbit should now have the new firmware and indicates its version number by the number of times the red LED flashes. Flashing twice indicates firmware version number 2. Finally, a few notes on troubleshooting. If a firmware upload fails for any reason, the module will not start anymore. However, you can repeat the upload process as often as necessary until it succeeds. Issue 1. With some audio cables and computer checks, there is a hum on the audio line which results in an incorrect file transfer. Therefore, make sure that you do not hear any noise at the module output as long as no file is being played. Orbit's dry audio output should be perfectly quiet. Issue 2. If you do not see any color change at the envelope button, even though the file is playing, you either forgot to press the sync button a second time or your audio is probably too quiet. Turn up the audio output of your player or the audio input of Orbit and start the whole upload procedure again. By the way, during the upload, the red LED shows you when the audio signal is clipping. It is best to adjust the volume so that the red LED is just off. If you have any issues, feel free to send us an email and we will find a way to get it working.